the virus has not gone away. In fact, it's increasing. We see that in the numbers, the cases that are the new cases within each city around the diocese. The bishop sent out a message that every city has gotten an increase in their cases. So just like for us to pray for that healing, for a cure for this virus, so that we can get back to our normal way of life, especially here in the church. Just pray for that, and pray for all the different needs that you also bring in today. A solution, has changed our lives. We trust in your goodness, that even so, as we're, our lives have been changed, that you are still with us. So Lord, help us to stay united during this time, as a church, as family, and as friends, as a community. Until that day when we can come back and be one physically here within our church. Lord, help us not lose our love for the Eucharist. Help us to know profoundly who we have before us, your Son Jesus and the consecrated host. Help us to understand this mystery so that we can wholeheartedly trust you in the way that you are present to us in our lives. So Lord, during this hour, we just ask that you help us to see you with eyes of faith, so that as we spend this time of prayer and adoration, we might draw a little closer to you than we were before this hour began, and that we might be strengthened by your blessings that you already have planned for us during this time, so that others will draw closer to you, so that others will know the powerful embrace that we know here in our parish. So bless us, Lord, especially those who are sick, with the virus especially. Bring about healing to their physical body, but more important, to their spiritual souls. And then we ask for protection for those who do not have the virus, that it will never enter into our lives. We pray for family and friends. We pray for our community. Mary, we also ask for your powerful intercession. As our Mother in Heaven, we, your children, cry out to you, and we ask that you voice our needs to your Son, Jesus. The need of healing, the need of protection. And so we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And so Jesus, we welcome you here as you welcome us. Let this time be one of union between our two hearts, so that our hearts might beat as one, and that we might become the person you want us to be in this world. Bless us and keep us strong. And so my friends, come as you are, with your weaknesses and with your strengths, and present yourself before the Lord. If you feel so led to come up all the way before the monstrous, kneel, spend your time in prayer, and be sensitive that someone else may want to come. We want to respect social distancing. Come if you would like, and then allow others to come as well.
Yeah. We just have a few minutes left, this hour of adoration. It just seems that when you spend the time with the Lord, it just kind of flies by quickly. I think that's a good sign, because when you enjoy spending time with someone, it does seem like time just flies by. I know Jesus enjoys spending time with us. That's why he wanted to come into this world, so that we could spend all eternity with him. So take this last few minutes of adoration just to be in his presence. Allow him to embrace you. Allow him to love on you. Just allow him to take you to the place you need to be within your spiritual life. And just enjoy. Just enjoy that friendship, that union you have with Jesus. Lord God, we thank you for being such a good God.
for blessing us even when we don't deserve it, for calling us back into your love when we have turned away, when we have sinned. We thank you for that part of your identity that is so merciful to us, really beyond our understanding. We claim that tonight because we know ourselves well. We know we don't love you perfectly in every way possible that we can, but we want to. So Lord, tonight before we leave, give us an extra outpouring of the Holy Spirit that might be possible within us, that we love you even more than we do now, that we stay committed to your ways, especially in the way that we love one another. Lord, increase our faith, especially during these times where so many are living out of fear. So many are doubting and losing faith. Lord, help us to be an example to them. Call them back using us as your instrument, so that they might see you through us. So my friends, tonight, let the Lord just bless you and increase that love you have for him. Remove all obstacles that may hinder that blessing. Put aside sin, put aside whatever it is that you know is not of God. Just allow him to come into your heart and bless you powerfully. Blessed be God.
Blessed be
his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus and the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be your glorious assumption.
Blessed be your glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph.
Blessed be God and his angels and his saints.
Blessed be God and his angels.